post-surgical, every single type of surgery, you should be fasting afterwards. The research shows that post-surgical fasting speeds up healing. The first is metabolic syndrome. I just talked about it. High hemoglobin A1C, pre-diabetes. Yep, they recommend for pre-diabetes that we look at fasting. Alzheimer's, they absolutely said that dementia and Alzheimer, memory loss, cognition, definitely improved by fasting. Certain cancers they looked at. The fourth one was post-surgical. Every single type of surgery, you should be fasting afterwards. Now, this doesn't mean you go into the hernia surgery and you come out and you're famished. I'm just saying maybe you might be, that you're like white knuckle it. And all of a sudden you're like, I can't eat. I need to stay in a fasted state. But if you are not white knuckling it, then when you come out of a surgery, stay in a fasted state. I can tell you, I just went through spinal surgery with my 89-year-old dad this August. And I gave him the same recommendation I'm giving you. I said, when you get out, let's make sure that you're in a fasted state. Let's keep you fasting. Unfortunately, my dad has glimmers of dementia. And by the time I showed up into the recovery room, he was eating a bowl of ice cream and he was being given food every 2 hours. It broke my heart. But the research shows that post-surgical fasting speeds up healing. The last one I just want to point out, because I told you I'd tell you the fifth one that the New England Journal of Medicine was really adamant about, was skin repair, wounds on your skin. So how many of you have gone on a 3-day water fast and your skin looks different? When I had my clinic, I could see them when they walked in the door. I could see the women be like, ooh, I'd be like, day two, day three, your skin color's changed. It's a healthier glow. You can literally visibly see it, and put in the comments if that was you. So yeah, phenomenal. Okay, so with a little bit of a technical difficulty, I just wanna say thank you for coming, because two things that I wanna say to you all. I absolutely adore doing this. So many of you thank me, and that's, you're too kind. Doctor means to teach. What does it mean to have knowledge and not share it with people for their benefit? So it warms my heart when you show up and you take this information and you apply it, because we are living in a time where personalized medicine needs to really come to the forefront. You healing yourself needs to be given a lot more credit. So when I look at all these beautiful comments and that you guys are leaving me in questions, and you keep showing up and you keep buying my books, like, I'll keep writing, I'll keep doing more videos as long as you guys are benefiting from it, because that's why I do this, is that I am here to make sure that the knowledge I know about how the body heals itself through things like fasting gets across to you and into your world so you can benefit from it. So thank you on that. So second thing, I'm really excited about my new book. It will be out in December. I've been in these really fun podcast interviews, listening to the podcasters who have read the book. It's deep. I have identified some really big parts of the brain that change as a woman goes through menopause. And I have identified what a lifestyle that needs to go with those brain changes so that you can get to 60, 70, and 80, a happier version of yourself. I will tell you that the one commonality, I've done about 30 podcasts so far, and I'm doing about 100 before December. But one of the most common things the podcasters are saying to me is they look at the subtitle. And the subtitle is How Menopause Rewires Your Brain for Mental Clarity, Increased Confidence, and Renewed Energy. If that is not your experience of aging, if that is not your mentality around menopause, please get the book. And we are doing a bunch of bonuses right now where you can get some early courses. Because if you're like me, I'm completely impatient. And when I order a book, I want it to come right away. So we have some bonuses, and you just need to go to agelikeagirlbook.com and you can see our bonuses there. And then you can start getting some of the information now. And you don't, I mean, obviously the book, you want the book, but when you pre-order the book, we'll give you some information now so you can get going with the principles that I taught in here. So let me know if you've ordered the book, share it with a friend. I'm going to end on this. And those of you who've been around me for a while know this. I am really, really getting frustrated with the conversation around menopause being that the only answer for women at this moment is hormone replacement therapy. Hormone replacement therapy can help millions of women. Bravo, very excited about that. But there is a huge learning curve. Not everybody can get on hormone replacement therapy and immediately feel incredible. It takes time to find your dose and figure out what's right for you. And it does not give you a free pass from lifestyle. So think of it like this. If you go on to Ozempic and you lose weight, did you change your metabolic health? Well, you might have just for that moment that you're on Ozempic. But the minute you're off Ozempic, if you gain weight back, you did not get to the root cause. When we're looking at a woman from 40 on, if HRT calls you, do it. But please dive into your lifestyle, and the first place to go is your metabolic health. This way, it's like it's not one or the other. It's all of it, right? So like, let's stop trying to be like pitting everybody against each other. Well, this person said this, and this person says this, and I'm supposed to do this and not do this. Lifestyle matters more for a woman after 40 than it's ever mattered in your whole life. So you put that patch on, you pick up this book, you pick up that book, you get some of the other great books out there, and you start to educate yourself on the lifestyle that will supplement with your HRT. If you're on Ozempic, you do the same. And then there may come a time you don't need to be on those medications. So I'm throwing that out there as I close this all down. And as always, I appreciate you all, and I will keep bringing you new science. That was really exciting for me to bring you. And those of you who joined late, you can go back to the beginning and look at the new science that I brought you today. But do not give up on yourself. Don't give your power over to your doctor. Don't give your power over to your health influencer. Don't give your power over to the patch or the injection. You heal you. That is how health works. It is in your hands. Okay? Deal? See you next week. Have an awesome day. Okay, are you fasting and you're still not losing weight? Check out this video because you might be missing a key part of your fasting experience that's gonna unlock weight loss. So if you think about it, all the humans that emerged out of that time have the gene that allows us to go without food. And that gene, they believe, is in all of us today.